In this segment of the Word tutorial, we're going to learn how to format a document. For the sake of time, I have an existing document. This document is just a generic one. I am giving credit to the website that I copied it from. I modified a couple of things in it, but basically this is not really my typing here. So we're going to learn how to change the formatting on it. Let's assume that we typed what we needed to type. Now we want to learn about some of the formatting capabilities. First, to select a section here, we can double-click on that heading, and it will select the whole section. Or drag it from beginning to end, or from end to beginning, hold down the mouse, and you'll be able to select that section. You can do the double-clicking also for paragraphs. It will select the whole paragraphs. If you go outside of the document and you triple-click, that'll select the whole document. Now for this document, let's suppose I wanted to change the font on this document. I select the whole thing. I can either hold down the mouse in the beginning here and drag it down like this, or triple-click outside of it. I want to change the font to Calibri. I clicked here on the drop-down, chose Calibri, and it applied the font. Now, under the size here, I could change the size as well directly from here. If I wanted to increase the font size, I can use this icon over here. To change the font type, italics, or apply additional properties, you simply select any of these options in here. You can click on this down arrow to each group of icons, and it will give you additional functions for those settings for the font. So if I click here on this arrow, this is where I can make additional modifications. If you always want any new documents to start with a particular font or a particular font size, you can come to this screen, adjust the properties, and then set this as the default. That's how you set the default font for all documents in Microsoft Word. Then you click on OK. Once you select a bunch of text, whatever that may be, notice that this quick toolbar will show up right above the text that you selected. This is commonly used tools so that instead of you having to reach out all the way here to the ribbon and the various functions, this is quicker for you to access and apply. Let's say that I selected this text and I applied various properties to this text, to this heading, and now I need to apply it to another section. Let's say I need to apply it right here. Instead of me having to go and change the properties and apply it to five different properties that I'm changing, I could actually copy the properties of the formatting from here, apply it to a different section of the document. And that is referred to as the format painter. So this is, we're copying the formatting of a specific section and applying it to a different part of the document. And the way that works is that we make the modifications in one spot. We go here under the format painter. It doesn't seem like much happened except for the icon that changed like this paintbrush. Now we go to the other section of the document, select it, and let the mouse go. It will apply the same properties of that item that we selected earlier. As far as copying and pasting, of course, you can copy a segment of it, and you can click on copy over here on the top left, or press Ctrl C, go to another section of your document, and then press Ctrl V, or press paste. Notice here under the paste option, you can do to keep the source formatting, you can merge the formatting, that means it's going to apply it with what your document has, or it's going to paste it as a picture, or it's going to paste it as a text, only removing any formatting. Typically you want to merge the formatting, or typically you simply want to press here paste. Show paragraph marks and other hidden formatting symbols. The spaces are represented with a dot here. And if there is more than one space, notice there are two dots here, so you could remove that other one. Right before the paragraph mark, there is another dot or an extra space in there, and this means that there is a return key or a paragraph mark in there. So that's using the hidden codes or symbols in a document. When you're done with it and you don't want to see this anymore, press it again. Before we move into more advanced features, you can also apply one of those styles. So styles are pre-formatted text, basically. So you have, and we'll get into this in the next session in more detail. But basically, for now, you can just go in here. You want to apply heading 1. It has this pre-formatted style. It's in blue. It's all caps and so on. And it's centered as well. If you choose to have a different one, you simply click on it, and it will apply it as needed.